I am a skillful volleyball player.
Wow, take a look at me. I'm really skillful. But how come when I step in the court? My arms are not my arms. My legs are not my legs. What will that happen?
I'm fighting, but my hands are trembling all over. How come? I studied and I burned my midnight oil yesterday, but how come today's test still
a blank?
Dear judges, dear friends, this is my first time to deliver my C1 speech. Hi. I remember that. And I did tell myself over and over again, do not be nervous, take it easy. But how come when something happened to me, I can never take it easy? Things happen in our life around people, especially when you deliver and when you encounter with those pressures and nervousness. When those comes, what would you do? People always think, can we do our best? What can we do with that? When dealing with those problems, nervousness, anxiety always come and invite to our life without any invitation. How? Are you able to deal with the pressures? Are you always take them easily? That's here comes the question. As for me, I always go by the technical. I always follow those rules suggested by other teachers or people from the internet. We use high technology in order to solve our problems. From time to time, people always post their sadness or sorrows or bad feelings on the internet. And somewhere over that corner might respond their answers or their suggestions for you to deal with the problem. And we might go to do some massage in our daily life. During the massage, we might yell because the massage, oh my God, the teacher over there, the trainer over there, might give you a very special service. Ooh, and you always scream! That's another style of relax. When troubles come, what would you do? Self-talking is one of the way. Do you know who always talk to themselves? Especially for the athletes. Athletes, when they are going to play in a match, when it's the match point or the game point, what would they do? They always go, break a leg. Go, I can do it. Yes, it's one of the ways to spur yourself. It's a stimulation for you to tell yourself you can do it. Those stimulations always improve oneself's performance. The last way will be if you have no other ideas to cope with those pressures or anxiety or nervousness, go to the doctor. The doctor always shares with you the most concisely question for you can deal with. And always, doctor can always give you the right way to deal with all your trouble. There. I was screwed up, said Kelly. I think I cannot do it, said Tracy. Am I able to do this? Said Ken. Everybody, just take it easy, because before you were born, you're with the talented. Let it in you. Let it abide within you. You can always do your best, which is only suit for you.
which is only for you to do it. The sun will still shine and smiles on your face. Just take it easy.
Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters and Tracy, where are you? Hi, Tracy. Tracy, that was a wonderful speech. I fully enjoyed it. And I actually, the first thing I enjoy is your value. Take it easy. I really should have taken it easy and don't show up here. And then the second thing I really like is your content. You have your thin line, take it easy, right away from the beginning. And then during the speech, you have take it easy, and the end, take it easy. So I'm sure 6 months from now, I will still remember that. And you also use the content, you use Toastmaster experience, your first experience, to demonstrate that, you know, it's not easy to take the easy. So that's great. And I also think that you are a very dynamic speaker. You are animated and move around, okay, and your voice is very strong. Good job there. Now, I would like to offer some personal suggestions in two areas. First is your speech. The second one is on your performance. First, your content. I think that your content, first you use the experience, the problems, your experience demonstrates the problem. However, the solution is just words. Internet, doctors, something. I really want to for you to show me how you use those information and get down to the turning point and learn how to take the easy. Because at the end, and during the speech, you use another sort of like preaching. So I would like to see that change. And also, for organization, you have those things arranged in a very different way. I would like for you to pack it a little bit tighter. For example, you can start with your mind. You know, think about athletes are talking to themselves. You can do it. You can do it. And then with the transition. Now, after the mind, now you have the body. Let's get massage and get relaxed. And then something else will come up. And then if those two did not work, then you go to the doctor or internet. So that will be a logic transition. Everything will flow smoothly and we'll remember that too. And then on your performance, I think the problem that you have that I can see is that you still did not forget about your script. So I think most of the time, you're not really talking to us. You are looking at us, but your eyes are dancing. Sometimes you move over here and you start talking to the other side. And you, even though you move, but you did not cover the both sides. I really need you to do this. Talk to us, and then plant your feet and deliver and focus your message. So in summary, ladies and gentlemen, Tracy did a great job as a test speaker. Now my recommendations are, first, in the content, tell stories. In organization, pack it a little bit more, and then use transitions more. And then thirdly, really talk to us. Memorize your speech much better, talk to us. And then Tracy, while we are taking it easy, next year you'll be working hard, and you'll be one of the top speakers in our district. Thank you very much.
Actually, think of a speech like an equilateral triangle. There are three points to it. There's the speaker, there's the speech, there's the audience. You take one of those away, you don't have a speech. You don't have communication, in fact. And what joins those parts together is equally important. If what joins them together is strong, the magic happens. The connection between audience and speaker comes alive. So I'd like to look, first of all, at the speech, the content, what our speaker gave us. Take it easy. There were a lot of examples. Playing volleyball, giving your C1 speech, writing exams. They were part of the problem. And then she gave us several solutions. Take a massage. See your doctor. There was a lot of content, almost too much. She gave us many, many examples. And if I could direct her, perhaps at this stage, towards giving fewer examples in depth, I think the content would have been even more powerful. We come to the speaker, the per method of delivery. Lovely, energetic, lively. But again, if I could make suggestions that would move her on a sort of rocket to success, I'd like to suggest things like coordinating her body language a little more closely to the content of what she's saying, and really delivering her speech using the power of pausing and silence in order to reinforce the points that she wants to make. So if I could just sum up then, a lovely, energetic, enthusiastic young speaker with a lot of ideas, and the points I'd like to give her to set her on the path to success. There are fewer examples linked to a central core that follows from the introduction through the body to a grand conclusion, delivered with a little more thought of for pausing and using silence. And then, with that strong connection between speaker and speech, the connection between that and the audience will be even more powerful.
I think the challenge of any good speaker is to be able to find a topic that would touch people, a good topic that really delivers a message that matters. An excellent or a champion speaker like our guest speaker Jim Key is able not only to give a good speech, but also to maximize the impact of that speech, that people can carry that message back home and say, I think about that. For me, Tracy is definitely an excellent speaker. Today, you know, Jim talked about expectations. So let's raise the expectation and help Stacy to become a world champion speaker. What should we do about that? So now, I wanted to say that Tracy really gives a speech of value because she talks about the topic, take it easy. We do need that because nowadays our society is so hectic that it's so stressful. We do need to take it easy. So the message really relates to all of us. I recognize the value of Stacy's speech. Also, let's take a look at the content of Stacy's speech. I think she was a very good actress. She knows how to get the audience's attention by opening her speech, by changing or shifting her places, three places. She talks about one scenario, the second scenario, so she covers the whole stage, and the third scenario, and she comes back. And she tells us also in her body, she talks about the ways that help you take it easy. For example, you can get a massage, and then also you can self-imagining, self-talking, and then also go to a doctor. However, I felt, we can see that Stacy is a really very good actress. However, maybe one thing you can take it to notice that when there are too many actions and acting, many people will forget or maybe not catch the strength of your message because people will put too much focus on your acting. So what you can do is also to correspond with the use of stage, is that maybe you can talk about putting your points into different points. For example, the first way you can take it easy is getting a massage and put your acting in this part. The second way you can take it easy is what? You can self-talk, get that image, your success. And then the third way to take it easy, so maybe you can melt your acting into the use of stage. I think that would be more powerful. Another suggestion is that I found that you only use 5 minutes of your time. So maybe you can add more personal stories to your speech. Because we can see from Jim's example, he talks about dreams, he talks about that, but we also see his struggle from not being a world champion and join the speech conference for twice, whatever. Maybe you can share us who you were. You were not able to take it easy, but now you can. What is the process? Overall, I think Stacy's strength as a speaker is your palatable lipid expression and also your confidence. And I want to thank you for giving this speech, and I congratulate you.